Welcome back to Motorhead Garage, presented by Dustless Blasting. Now, you may be pulling a big trailer like ours with an A-frame, and your jack probably looks like ours, all rusted out, crank handle, blocks of wood down there. Well, for me, cranking, I don't like that, first and foremost. Second, it never extends enough, so I gotta go get some blocks of wood or a block of wood, try to level it up, real nightmare. Third option, you can manhandle that thing. Me, I'm not gonna manhandle it. You maybe, not for me. Bulldog's got the solution. 4,000 pound jack for the front of that thing, that's what I'm talking about.
Absolutely, I'm frankly shocked that you allow something this crummy looking on the front of your wardrobe trailer over here, but it is what it is. We're gonna upgrade you from the Stone Age really into the Space Age with this piece. And as John said, a 4,000 pound A-frame electric jack here from Bulldog that is packed with features from this one wire installation, single wire, so even if you're fearful of electronic stuff, this is no sweat. You have a multiple mounting option location here. You got multiple holes here in this ring, so when you set this into the tongue of the trailer, you can have it justified the way you want it to access the switches. We have lights integrated into the unit, one forward facing to help you line up your trailer at night when you're backing up, and two rearward facing. If you run a weight distribution style hitch, you're gonna use those lights at night to help hook up those spring bars on there. My favorite feature of this whole thing is the spring-loaded plunger pin. The reason this is so cool is because when you pull up and you get ready to use the jack, you pull the pin out and the foot comes out, the longest foot in the industry, so you're not going to have your wood blocks around anymore. As this foot drops down, the pin disengages. And then as you start applying the jack, it pushes the foot up and you have a positive locking mechanism here, which you did not have with this piece. So it's a good safety feature. Up here on the top of the unit, you also have a level. You got this bubble style level that will allow you to make sure that your unit is straight, level, and that's very important, especially with a weight distribution hitch. Everything needs to be on the level when you're putting your spring bars in. The last thing, if you're wondering about why it's a 4,000 pound jack and who has 4,000 pounds on the tongue of their trailer, nobody should, but this is going to be used to lift both the trailer and the unit that's pulling it in some situations to get that level you need. That's why it's the 4,000 pound capacity.
And you know, looks is important to me. So it's got a fade resistant cover here. You got marine grade switches, and I really like the top here. We can pop this off right on the top. We can pop this plug off, and if the battery goes dead or you're not charging it, you can go ahead and manually use it. So it's going to work either way. Now you're talking about fearful electronics. I love electronics. I'll tell you what, you take the front end of that one, I'll take the back end, I'll start doing electronics. Let's hit it.
Let's do it. Yeah, very easy installation. We have already removed John's horrible looking jack from previous, so now we're going to be able to drop in the Bulldog unit here. Again, you can note the ring that you'll see coming into the tongue of the trailer here, the multiple mounting locations. We're gonna have our switches facing out. That's best for us. You could have them facing right or left if you wanted to. Now, John, I'm gonna pass you.
Yeah, if you just feed me this wire through here.
Deluxe wire.
Yep, we're gonna take the wire back here. We got some good wire practices. You wanna make sure you get a good connection. Couldn't be any more simple. The cool part is it grounds, case grounded to the frame, also has some internal protection, so you don't need any kind of fuse here. We can go right to the positive battery terminal. I'm just gonna take a terminal here. I'm going to go ahead and pop it in here, make sure I got my white wire size, come down with my crimping tool. I'll go ahead and crimp it and get it ready to go.
And John, as you're working on that, I've slid the unit in. I've gone ahead and put our locking collar on there with our plunger pin. I'm going to stick our foot in here. I'm just going to, before I bolt this down, it's important to get the foot in. That way we don't have a clearance issue. Foot's going to slide up in there. Now I can go ahead and get myself lined up. I'll start working on my bolts. What are you doing back there, John?
And that's it. I just got the little eye hook. I'm gonna put it right in there. Once I get this in, I'm gonna get the terminal started back here, get it tightened up. You should have power supply up there, so we're almost ready to go. Snug up the battery, get it on there. I'll come back later and I'll reroute some of this a little bit better so it's actually nice and tucked in there real secure and nicely so we don't have any issues, especially when we're towing down the road.
Good hardware supplied by Bulldog. You know, this is a company that's been around almost 100 years and they've been making innovative products the whole time. And this is one that's really gonna save people a lot of time and hassle. All right, John, that means we are done. I'm gonna pull the pin, you do the honors, all right?
All right.
All right.
Let's try the lights first. Hey, we got lights, that's nice.
Plunge pins out, lift us.
Here we go.
So watch, the pin's gonna catch in a second here. Right about there.
There we go, look at that. Oh man.
It's a beautiful thing.
Wow, that's beautiful. You know what that means? I'm not gonna run and get in the air-conditioned truck anymore. I'll stay here and hook up the trailer. You go get the truck. You go take a short break. We'll be right back with more Motorhead Garage.
Once a diva, always a diva.